So I figured it was about time for me to address the Bulgarian weightlifting system. You know, I've had a lot of people comment to explain the system and talk about it a little bit further. But I think it's a relatively simple system to understand. The thing that I would like to explain to you guys is that if you're not doing exactly the steps laid out by Ivan Abajayev himself, you're not doing the Bulgarian weightlifting system. You can be doing things that are Bulgarian-esque, but those things are not proven. The medals that were won by the Bulgarian weightlifting team through the coaching of Ivan Abajayev were because of a direct and pointed system. So I think this video by Juggernaut Training Systems lays out this system perfectly. Max AITA trained under Abajayev, and if anyone can really speak on the system itself, it's him. So if you're curious to know more about the Bulgarian weightlifting system, please check that video out. I'm gonna summarize it really quickly, but you definitely need to watch the entire video. I'm gonna have that linked in the description. But here is the breakdown of the video. So first off, Abajayev was being fed a lot of high-level lifters. These weren't beginner, intermediate, or even advanced lifters. These were, by all accounts, elite lifters, at least within Bulgaria. Now, this is a really important point that I think a lot of people forget. If you want to do the Bulgarian system, how good are you to start with? If you're an elite lifter or a national level lifter, odds are you've had enough reps at the 70 to 80% range and you've worked technique enough. So in a system where Abajayev reduces the sets outside of 90% to maximal, it's not as big of a deal because for a beginner, intermediate, and even an advanced lifter, these lifts sub 90% are very important, especially if you want to fix any technique errors. Another very important part of the Bulgarian system is that it is revolved around competition. The lifters on the Bulgarian weightlifting team had control competitions or mock meets once a week. They also had competitions 12 or 12 plus times per year. These lifters also came from a different socioeconomic place than most hobbyists. In a Barbell Shrug podcast, Max gives a pretty cool example of the gardener versus the landscaper. You have the hobbyist gardener who is still trying to get work done, but really enjoys their work. And then you have the landscaper who is all about work and it's all about making that money. This is the similar idea between a hobbyist and a professional lifter or someone within the Bulgarian system. This is definitely not a hobby for them. This is a way of life. This is their job. This is their work. Then in that Barbell Shrug podcast, which I will have linked below, Max talks about what one session would look like. So a Monday morning session would take about 4 hours. They would front squat to maximum, take a 30-minute break, snatch to maximum, take a 30-minute break, clean and jerk to maximum, take another break, and then finally they would front squat to maximum again. Then they would take about a 2-hour break, and they would pretty much repeat the exact same session for their middle of the day session, and then their evening session might take them a little less time. So we're talking about lifters who spend anywhere from 8 to 10 hours in a gym. Now they're not working the entire time, but they're getting maximal efforts over the course of the day. And this is probably the biggest, most important thing that people who claim to be training Bulgarian miss out on. So I'm gonna pull up this article called Bulgarian Training Simplified, as if the training system wasn't simple enough. Now this is a T Nation article that if I type in Bulgarian weightlifting into Google, this is the first thing that pops up. So basically the article does a pretty poor job of laying out what Max did a really good job of laying out. But then it basically talks about the modifications. So the first one is more variability. So right away, we're looking at something that is a concept that is outside of Bulgarian training. Max specifically says that variance is the enemy in Bulgarian training. There is front squatting, snatching, and clean and jerking. And that's pretty much it. Sometimes they would back squat. Rep max cycling. Now this is one that I really, really disagree with. Basically, the author talks about cycling the rep maxes. So instead of working off of your one rep max, you start working off of your two rep max and your three rep max. Again, this is a concept that vastly opposes the Bulgarian system. There is a one rep maximum, and that's what we're working off of. What you're doing when you say two rep max or three rep max, Essentially, you are just working off of a lower relative intensity. So if you look at a rep max chart, your 3 rep max is gonna be right around 92% of your 1 rep max. Your 2 rep max is gonna be right around 95% of your 1 rep max. And this is for the powerlifting movement specifically. And that's what the guy in the T Nation article is talking about. So if you start working off of percentages off of your 2 rep max or your 3 rep max, you're just taking, you know, 90% or 80% of 92%, or in the 2 rep max case, you're doing 80% or 90% of 95%. I'm sorry to say, but that is nothing even remotely close to the Bulgarian system. When you start to take relative intensity for strength lifts like the deadlift or the bench press or the back squat, if you start increasing the load, which this guy does, right? If you're working off of your 3 rep max, then the next week you're working off of your 2 rep max, then your 1 rep max, essentially all you're doing is increasing your intensity. You're increasing your relative intensity. Max AITA specifically says that there is no periodized structure to Bulgarian weightlifting. And what this person on the T Nation article laid out is periodization to a T. He just doesn't specifically say it. Here's my favorite one by far, one daily session. Now this, to me, embodies, at least on the weightlifting side, the people who think that they're doing Bulgarian. People who come in for 1.5 to 2 hours per day and they lift maximal in the snatch, clean and jerk, and front squat think that they're doing Bulgarian weightlifting. So here we have you, right, maxing out once per day, and then here is where we have all of the things that you're missing out on. I personally think that the term Bulgarian is really just a buzzword or buzz term, if you will. People want to say that they train like a Bulgarian when really they're just maxing out. The people that bother me specifically are those who talk about the efficacy or lack thereof of maxing out every day. That's your system. The system that's proven is the one that I laid out before you. The system that you're deciding to do, the modified one, is proven by absolutely nothing. Or if it is proven by something, it's proven by periodization, which is a term that is diametrically opposed to Bulgarian weightlifting. Anyways, that's the end of my rant. If you like this video and you like educational videos for weightlifting specifically, please subscribe and I'll see you in the next one.